Hello and welcome to today's video that is made possible by my Patreons. If you also appreciate my content and would like to support my channel, don't hesitate to visit my Patreon page, the link is in the description. As you know, the violin that I'm making in the violin making series is almost finished, and in the following video that will be online the 11th of August, I'm going to put the pegs on and the fittings. Pegs, tailpiece and end button, and of course the bridge and strings and everything, and make it playable. But that means that I needed new pegs, and I wanted to put something better than what I put on the regular instruments. So I reached out to Akura Meister, which is a producer from India who makes fittings for both instruments, violins, viola, cellos. And we discussed a little bit, and they said that they would support my channel and send a set of fittings for the violin that I'm making, but also a couple of extra sets to see and to try out. This is the package that they sent. I haven't seen them yet, although the package is a couple of days on my desk. Let me open it and find out what they sent. There is a letter, let me see the right. Oh, it's only a paper for the customs, not so interesting. And the boxes, let's open this. We have a set in ebony together with its chin rest, and these are going to on my violin. I'm going to mount them in the upcoming video. A set in boxwood and a set in tin tool. I'm going to talk about tin tool a bit later. Now let's take a bit closer look to all the sets. Akura Meister makes two different series of fittings, the Preciso and the Ultimo. The Preciso is their basic series and the Ultimo is a bit more high-end. The Preciso series comes in boxwood, tin tool and ebony, and all of them in boxwood and ebony trimmings. The Ultimo series comes in boxwood, rosewood, ebony and snakewood, and again all of them with boxwood and ebony trimmings. The pegs and tailpieces come in two models, heel and heart. The metallic parts of the chinrests are made in titanium or hypoallergenic stainless steel. Finally, there are some other small details where there is a choice, like the thickness of the shaft, the length of the tailpiece, and also the material that is under the chinrest that might be cork or silicone. As you understand, I want to try one of the sets, especially the tin tool ones. That is a kind of material that I have never used in the past. And I have a French violin that has rosewood pegs. French violin makers from the beginning of the past century used to use rosewood, but they are becoming a bit too short. And also we have the known problem with rosewood, that it is in the CITES list. So I'm going to mount these pegs, tailpiece and end button on this instrument. The pegs are on their place, and I have to say that they look very nice, but also that they are very good to work with. The wood is of a very good quality, nice and compact. And that means that it doesn't break, which is often the problem with cheap pegs. The wood is not very compact and is a bit soft, and it breaks easily when you are working with a peg scraper. Now we can go ahead and put the end button on place. And the end buttons of Akura Meister are very special because, as you might have seen in the intro, they come apart. The center part of the end button comes off and leaves a hole from which you can have a look to the soundpost. That means that when you are working on an instrument and changing the soundpost a little bit, you can control it without having to remove the strings and everything and the end button to have a look through the hole. And finally, I can mount the instrument, and that means that I have to put the tailpiece on its place. I'm going to use my own tail gut, as they don't provide one, and I'm going to put one fine tuner for the E string. Cello tailpieces do have 4 incorporated fine tuners. The tailpiece looks also very nice and has on its back also their logo. The violin is finally mounted, and I have to say that I like these pegs and tailpiece a lot. I like that in tool wood it works as well as rosewood, but is a little bit more reddish in its color. But it looks very nice, especially on this instrument. And of course, I also look forward to use the ebony ones. I will use them on the upcoming video, the last video of the Making a Violin series. And my overall impression is that these fittings are of a very high quality. They are very well made and the woods look like being very high quality. I will know better after I have used also the ebony ones. What I also like is that they have put some effort in the packaging with some information on the back, and looks very nice also if you put it in a display in your shop. So that's it for today's video. Many thanks to Akura Meister for sending me these fittings. Don't forget to visit their website, the link is in the description. Many thanks to the Patreons for supporting the channel. My Patreon page link is also in the description. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time again. Bye bye!